I don't wanna live with this feeling any longer than I have to, but also I don't want you to be gone. So I talk about you all the time, including the last day that you were alive. And I hang your pictures around the house for me to surprise myself with and cry. Everybody that used to know us seems concerned, but if they knew that when you enter my mind, I'm full of the love that illuminated our house for all those years and made this dancing child who tears through the days with a brilliant sang along with, but you're sleeping out in the yard now. What am I saying? No one is sleeping. You don't even have a dead body anymore. It was taken away. I went and wrote a check and got a cardboard box full of your ashes and a little plastic bag with your necklace, and I drove back home truly alone. I guess I didn't bury it deeply enough when I poured out your ashes beneath the three witch hazels that you planted in the yard a few years ago in a triangle for us, where me and the kid were rolling in the grass the other day, and I saw actual chunks of your bones, bleached and weathered, unerasable. You're still out there in the spring upheaving, coming out of the ground into air. Is that exact fragment your finger that once caressed me not that long ago? I still can feel it. And is that other shard a piece of your skull that once contained the wild brain that used to overflow with loving? Undiscovered and gone, and now just shrapnel. From the earth.